Good morning, students of class 8. Now, today I will discuss on the chapter, that is, it is the revision part of the chapter, that is materials, metals and non-metals. Now, in the previous classes, we have already discussed all the topics regarding this chapter. Now, today I will discuss only some of the portion from this chapter. So, first of all, start with the element. What is an element? So, element found in the earth crust. What is earth crust? That is in the nature, in the ore form or in the compound form, it is found in nature. And sometimes it may be also artificial. Now, the element which is further not breakable, which is further not breakable to any subpart, then it is an having an individual identity. Having an individual identity and which is further not breakable is known as an element. Now, the elements are arranged in the chemistry, that means they are arranged in the chemical world in the periodic table. The periodic table is the arrangement of the element, and the up to the discovered element is 122. Now, around 122 element. Before that, there are 115 elements in the periodic table. So, out of 115 elements in the periodic table, we are classified them as three parts. That is, elements have been classified as metals, non-metals and metalloids. We have studied the definition of that is metal, non-metals and metalloids. Now, out of 115 elements, 92 is natural and 23 is man-made. Out of 115 element, 115, 92 is natural and 23 is man-made. Now, the metals, out of 115 elements and 92 natural and 23 man-made. So, out of these, there are only 7 metalloids. 7 metalloids, non-metals is 18 and 19 are metal. So, 90 metals, 19 non-metals and 7 metalloids. These are the classification of elements in the periodic table. Now, next part, we have to go with the definition of that is the metal. So, there the question is how many elements found in the nature, that means the 115 elements, and out of that there are 92 is natural and 23 is man-made, and 90 is metals, 18 non-metals and 7 is the metalloids. Now, first of all, the definition of metal. So, you may write down the clearly definition of metal, that a solid material which is typically hard, shiny, malleable, ductile and sonorous, with good conductor of heat and electricity, is known as metal. So, the materials which is typically hard, shiny, malleable, ductile, sonorous and good conductor of heat and electricity is known as metal. In the same way, we may write down the definition of metalloids. You may write it down, non-metals. Non-metals, materials which are soft and dull in appearance. These are all physical properties. So, out of the definition, we may write materials which are soft and dull in appearance, comma, which breaks down into powdery mass, which breaks down into powdery mass when tapping by an hammer, not sonorous and poor conductor of heat and electricity, is called non-metals. So, repeat once, materials which are soft and dull in appearance, which breaks down into powdery mass when tapping by a hammer, non-sonorous and poor conductor of heat and electricity, is known as non-metals. Examples are carbon, sulfur, etc. Now, the last point there was, what is metalloids? Metalloids is also the materials which having the common property of metals and non-metals. That is arsenic, antimony, these are the examples of non-metal. Now, we know the definition and we can make a differentiation with respect to these physical properties, and this is also a question, that differentiate between metal and non-metal with respect to physical properties. Now, in physical properties, these are the physical properties, that is appearance and also the hardness and also malleability, ductility. Third one is the conductivity to heat and electricity, and also there is a property that is stretching strength, or stretching strength, that means tensile strength. Tensile strength, that is the bonding in between the particles of the element. It will be discussed later on. Now, next point, that is the chemical properties. So, first point, that is reactions with oxygen. Chemical properties. So, if the questions come that write four definition, write the four properties, four physical properties of materials. Write four physical properties of materials. You may write it down, that the appearance, that is dull, or in the hardness or malleability, ductility, conductance to heat and electricity. These are the physical properties. Now, under the chemical properties, first is reaction with oxygen. We have done it in the classes, that is reaction with oxygen, that is metals react with oxygen to form oxide, and also non-metals react with oxygen to form non-metallic oxide. Now, the property of oxide can be detected by dissolving it in water, and the property, that is it as it is acidic or basic, can be detected by using a indicator that is known as litmus paper. Litmus is an indicator. It is also a natural indicator. Now, reaction with water, that is metal plus oxygen forming metallic oxide. When dissolved with water, it forms a base. And we know that the litmus is blue in base. So, blue color of litmus in this solution. In the same way, non-metals react with oxygen to form non-metallic oxide. When non-metals react with oxygen to form non-metallic oxide and it dissolves in water, then it forms an acid, non-metallic element plus oxygen, non-metallic oxide plus water, it will form an acid. So, red color of litmus paper is used to identify it. So, this is the reactions of metal and non-metals with oxygen. Now, there is the two question that given in your NCERT book, that is in the word equation form, that is iron plus oxygen plus H2O. Iron plus oxygen plus H2O. We will try to write down the word equation and also the symbol. Iron plus oxygen plus water H2O, the answer will be Fe2O3 XH2O. It is the last. Fe2O3 XH2O. Another one is Mg, magnesium plus oxygen, that is magnesium oxide. Here you will write down the iron oxide. Iron oxide. Magnesium oxide, the formula is MgO. This is the equation given in your NCERT book. Now, write down some questions from the physical property that name two metals which are liquid at room temperature. Name two metals which are liquid at room temperature. Answer is mercury and gallium. Mercury, mercury, and gallium, gallium. Next question, name two non-metals which are lustrous. Name two non-metals which are lustrous. Answers is iodine and graphite. Iodine and graphite. Graphite. Name the hardest naturally occurring non-metal. Next question. Name the hardest naturally occurring non-metal. Answer is diamond. D-I-A-M-O-N-D. We all know the answer of this question. The question is, what name is given to the property for which they can be beaten into sheets? The answer will be malleability. In the same way, what name is given to the property for which they can be made to the thin wire? This is the ductility. Next question is, name a non-metal which is a good conductor of electricity. The answer will be graphite. Another one, that is the when suspension of rust tested with litmus paper, what observation is done on the litmus paper? Question is, the when suspension of rust is tested with litmus paper, what observation is done to the litmus paper? The answer will be, there is no change in the color of the litmus paper, as blue remains blue and the red remains red, because the iron oxide or the rust is basically insoluble in water. And as it is insoluble in water, and litmus can test the nature of the solution in the aqueous medium, so it does not show any color change. But later on we can prove it that the rust is acidic, basic in nature, when it reacts with acid. So answer will be, there is no change in the color of the litmus paper when the suspension of rust is tested with it. That's all for today. On the next day, I will revise on the reactions of water with metals and non-metal. Carefully, you make the note for the your exam which is upcoming, and also the questions which I tell today to you, note it down in your exercise book. Thank you.